Alabama, Santa Rosa County, and then Baldwin County.
In fact, the eye wall overall, the structure of the hurricane looks about as well organized as it has during the last couple of days. And we can see the barrier islands in here, the northern part of the eye, just about getting on shore. Dauphin Island over here with the powerful squalls coming on shore there. And then we have Gulfport, Biloxi, Pascagoula in here getting into some of the intense squalls just to the north of the eye of the hurricane.
And we mentioned the heavier rainfall. Some areas have already had over a foot of rainfall. There's our Doppler radar estimate. And as you can see here, Stu, since 8 o'clock in the morning, we have seen as much as a foot of rainfall around Pensacola, more rain to come, and we have just gotten the latest ob out of Biloxi.
And if I'm reading this correctly, it has sustained winds at Keesler Air Force Base of 53 knots, which is about 60 miles an hour, a gust to 109 knots, is that correct, which is about 125 miles per hour. So in fact, the worst part of the hurricane, the eye wall, is now coming on shore, and it's going to be a rough couple of hours as it does so.
Okay, let's get back to the rainfall. As we mentioned, the rainfall has been prolific so far, Stu. You know, a typical hurricane, you get, say, 5 or 10 inches of rain. But in this situation, we've already had upwards to a foot of rainfall. And with a slow movement of the storm, we could easily double that total in some areas.
Yeah, there's just all kinds of bad things going on with this hurricane here. We have the extremely heavy rains, which have already caused rainfall-induced flooding. We have the winds coming on shore, not only bringing that moisture, but also causing the water to pile up. And then now, as the hurricane circulation right around the center perhaps tightens up a little bit, then we have the storm surge itself right near where the eye is coming in.
Now, what about the potential for some of this rain to wrap back around towards New Orleans later today? Because so far, New Orleans has done gotten off fairly easily.
Right. If the hurricane continues moving mainly north or north-northwest, and it does not wrap a lot of that rain around, then New Orleans would continue to be spared the worst of the rain. If, however, it were to slow down, wobble a little bit to the west and wrap some of that rain around, they'd get some more. But for the most part, as has been the case with this hurricane for the last several days even, a lot of the worst effects, from the coastal effects to the winds and the rain, are from the middle part of the hurricane off to the east.
And the other aspect of the hurricane, from the middle part off to the east and northeast, that quadrant, is the risk of severe weather and tornadoes. Tornado watch we can update you on has been extended. The tornado watch, well, we have the tornado watch there. There we go. There's the tornado watch until 1 o'clock in the morning, rather 1 o'clock in the afternoon central time. So that continues to be a problem, because twisters have spun up. We've had two touchdowns. We've had some damage. So again, we have the risk of tornadoes, too. We have the heavy rains, the flooding, the flash flooding, which continues, and now the storm surge, and those wind gusts, as we mentioned, in Biloxi, just reported at 125 miles an hour as Hurricane George makes landfall.
And gusts like that can cause structural damage to buildings, blow in windows, that sort of thing, cause some roof damage. So people that are experiencing that sort of thing should observe tornado safety rules. Even though it's not a tornado, we have winds of that magnitude. Get away from the exterior portion of the building. Get inside the middle of the building, where you're best protected from the outside.
Yeah, stay away from the windows.